Hey guys, I'm back with an updated tutorial on installing SideQuest. Setting it up is very easy, but some people are having a hard time getting it to work. And my guess is that they don't have the right USB cable, or their operating systems are not supported like Windows 7 and Windows 8. Before I show you the steps, here are the requirements. Number 1. A laptop or desktop computer running on Windows 10 64-bit, macOS 10.12 and above, or Linux. And no, you don't need a high-end or a gaming computer for this since you won't be playing on your PC. You'll just be moving files from your PC to your headset. Number 2. The tablet or phone you use to set up your Quest or Quest 2. Number 3. A USB-A to USB-C or a USB-C to C cable. Here are the cables that I have that work. The Oculus Quest charging cable. This cable is not meant for data transfer, but it could work on small downloads like BMBF for Beat Saber. I didn't get to test the cable for the Quest 2, but I think that it might work the same way. The Mac charging cable. Just like the Quest cable, it works most of the time, but I wouldn't rely on it for big data transfers. My Samsung Galaxy phone charging cable. The newer ones are USB-C on both ends, so those could work. This USB A to C cable I got from Miniso. My anchor cable. This is USB 3 on one end and USB-C on the other. This is my preferred cable when sideloading big games and apps. So those are the requirements, and if you have everything ready, let's get started with the steps. Step 1. Using the same account linked to your Quest or Quest 2, log into the Oculus Developer website and verify your developer account. You can do this by adding a credit card or your mobile number to your Facebook account. I'm gonna do it using my mobile number. If there is only credit card as the option and you don't have one, here's a Reddit post that could help you. Step 2. Click this drop-down box on the left and click Create to create an organization. Step 3. Enable developer mode on your phone or tablet where your Oculus app is installed. Step 4. This is for Windows only. If you're in a Mac or Linux, skip to step 5. Click the link in the description to download ADB drivers. It comes in a zip file, so you need to extract the contents before you can install. Don't double-click the zip file. You have to right-click it and then extract. If you don't have an extract option, you can download 7-Zip for free. Just look for any extract option under the 7-Zip submenu if you're using 7-Zip. Open the extracted folder and the folders within that folder until you find Android_WinUSB. Right-click it and then install. Step 5. Go to sidequestvr.com to download SideQuest. I'm on Windows, so I'm going to download SideQuest for Windows. Step 6. Enable USB debugging. This area on the top left shows the status of the connection, and it currently shows that the headset is not detected. So now, connect your headset to your PC using a working cable. Status will change to an authorized allow in headset. So put your headset on and you'll see this message. Click Always Allow and then OK. Your device name and local IP will now appear, which means you can now start sideloading and enjoy the other SideQuest features. If you can't connect to SideQuest despite doing all the steps right, check this Reddit post. If this Oculus Link message box won't go away after clicking Not Now, go to your task manager by pressing Ctrl-Alt-Delete on your computer's keyboard and end these three tasks. If you have any more questions, I'll link the SideQuest service desk in the description.